Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the channel. This is Henu Jr. And this is going to be the start of Kingdom Hearts. Now, I know we just started Ratchet & Clank previously, and we can reliably go one planet an episode. I don't think it's going to be the case. Not with this one. The planets are a little denser, and there's a lot more that you can do on said planets. So, we're gonna have to figure out what the setup's gonna be, but we can use this episode, maybe a few others, and figure out what we're gonna do. I know this episode's gonna be very heavily based around, level grinding, and a few other things. So, I'm gonna go ahead and start this up. Ooh, which do I want? You know what? I've not done it before. Let's do expert. Let's have the vibration on. Not that this thing has... maybe. I think this thing has vibrations. It just never uses them. Yes.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
So, from what I've seen, So for those of you who don't know, which I don't see how you couldn't, but, whoops. This is kind of like the tutorial area of the game for Kingdom Hearts. This is right here, probably one of the biggest set of choices you could possibly make. Now, the idea is that depending on what you decide to choose will alter what you gain. So, if I could figure out, alright, guess it doesn't want to work. So, there's a lot of choices that you can go with. But basically you have to pick up one and drop the other. Obviously that's going to change some things. For instance, you would pick up the sword, which would boost up your physical strength, but then you have to choose whether or not you want to drop the shield, which will lower your defense, which will ultimately end up also boosting your magic. Or you could pick the sword and drop the staff, dropping your magic, but boosting your defense. And there's a few other iterations of that. Ultimately, there's 6 different combos that you can get. And not only does it alter the stats, it also alters your skills that you learn as you're playing through the game. The one that's probably the most balanced is probably taking the shield and then dropping either the sword or the staff, depending on how you want to do it. The reason I say that's the best setup is because it maxes out the amount of slots for your items at 8. So you can carry 8 different items with you at all times. I rarely ever use the items, but as you're going through the game, when you get to later areas, it's best to have at least some kind of a backup in case you don't have the magic to pull off healing or whatever. So I know for a fact I want to take the shield, if I can get up there. There we go. So, right off the bat, that gives me either a strength of 4 or 5, a guaranteed defense of 4, and then a choice of either 3 AP or 1 AP. So, MP stays the same at 2, and max item slot at 8. So, I do want this. Now, if I drop the sword, I'll get the best amount of AP to start off with, which I can't even gain anything real major for a while. But, are you kidding me? Thank you. So if I drop the sword, I do lose a point to strength, but I gain 2 points to AP, and I'm pretty sure I'll have some decent mana throughout. So that's what I want to do. Alright, so, of course with that I'm not going to learn scan until 21, that's a little late, if you ask me, but it is what it is. I'm going to be like level 10 before I leave the first area anyway, so. Alright, then, the other important thing guess the questions. So, let's see here. Because there's a few questions that they have you answer. And depending on the questions that you take, alters how the story goes, kind of. Okay, not the story per se. It's the what do you want to call it? Your level set. So as you, depending on the questions that you answer, it will alter how and how much experience you require to gain levels as you go through the game. There's three setups that you can have. It is either very easy in the beginning and very hard in the end. The flip side of that, easy in the beginning, or easy beginning, hard at end, hard at the beginning, hard, easy at the end, or straight, the set, it's leveled out throughout the whole thing. So it's never difficult in any one part of the game to level up. I like that middle point. Yes, usually I'm overleveled as heck and I'm level 100 before I finish the game off anyway, but it makes more sense if I can make leveling easier throughout the whole process, or at least the same. Things are way more difficult than they need to be when it's difficult to level up. Period. Although I suppose I could always go difficult to start and easier as I get through it. I might actually do that, just because that is helpful. Not really knowing this. Come on. makes more sense. Done double checking crap. Like I mentioned, here it is. This is the area where you're asked certain questions, and depending on your answer, will alter how Sora levels up. Like I said, the choices are either faster up to level 50, slower after. Slower up to level 50 and then faster, or even all throughout. And I think the easiest thing to do is going to be slower at first up to level 50 and then faster after. I only say that because getting up to level 50, that's going to be relatively easy, even if it's slow. But then after, once I hit level 50, it should be much easier to get to level 100 after that, and I don't need to grind nearly as much as I usually do. So, this is gonna seem really bad, but so, my prized possessions. I don't like these answers. I really don't. Be strong. Okay, so it's not all so bad. It's just the first one didn't really sit well with me. You like collecting neat things. You want to be strong. You're afraid of being indecisive. Your adventure begins at the dead of night. Your road won't be easy, but a rising sun awaits your journey's end. Basically means you're starting off relatively rough, but as you get later into the game, it'll become easier and easier for you. I like that. The day you will open the door is both far off and very near. Now, there is... there's an odd setup. I'm pretty sure there's a way you could rearrange how you answer those and we'll give you different ones. But those three ones are the main ones. So it's kinda in the middle there. I don't know how that all works out. I know they give you three different choices for storyline run. Or not storyline, leveling run. So. Just about done with the intro to all this. Yay. I don't know if this is gonna be as... what's the word? Viable half-hour episodes. but I mean, if I do half-hour episodes, it's going to be a lot longer. There's going to be a lot more videos, just to say. Yay. It's already been 20 freaking minutes. It shouldn't have even been that. But I've been so busy dealing with other things. Oh, okay. So, yeah, I need 10 more to level up. Jeez. So yeah, 24 just to gain a level. Choices, easy beginning or the same the whole way through, you level up here. I don't know if this thing gives the 10 experience. I could see that. I could see him giving 10. I would be very surprised if he didn't give 10 experience, at least. Life. go. Yep, and you gave me at least 10 experience. So, very nice, very nice. I'm now level 2. I almost always leave the island at level 10, so...
Give me a break, Kairi.
Sora, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yeah, sure.
Say, Kairi, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you know this. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh? What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
Oh, alrighty then. I forget just how goofy they all look in the first game. It's been a while. I've played all the way up through the third game. It's crazy. It doesn't look right anymore. First game looks so odd. Can you get in the rest of the supplies? So 2 logs, 1 cloth, 1 rope. 2 logs, a cloth, and a rope. That's pretty easy. So, log 1. I think it's over there. No, right. Ah, no. There we go. Pretty sure. Yep, there it is. So that's 2. There's a few people here that we can fight. Holy shit, he gave a lot of experience. Because I was at 14, he boosted straight up to 41. Well, fuck. Alright. Maybe on the easy end, you get a couple of levels. Alright, let's find that rope and cloth, and I think we'll call it good for an episode. lock should be right up here. Yep. Cool. I hate that. The end of this episode right here. With that, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please like, subscribe, all that good YouTuber stuff, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.